So, welcome. You don't have to say anything. You've got your masks on. We're supposed to not be singing loud or shouting loud, but welcome. It's really good to finally be here for a 10:30 service. I was thinking just now, Jill said, make sure you welcome people who are here for the first time. It occurred to me that actually I'm welcoming myself, because this is the first time that I've been here for a 10:30 service. So, welcome me. Thanks. It is genuinely so exciting to be gathering with you here. As you can see, it's been quite a difficult process. We've crossed lots of T's, we've dotted lots of I's, we've done other things with other bits of the alphabet just to make sure that we are keeping everyone as safe as possible. It does mean that the service will look a little different this morning from the way it normally looks. However, it's still really good that we can gather here in person to worship, and also you can see various cameras around. That's because we'll be doing Christ Church Without Walls. We'll be putting that up on YouTube for those who are unable to be here today later this afternoon. So a quick wave to a camera just to make sure they feel welcome as well. Would you believe the first thing I have to do as vicar is read some bands, which is fantastic news. So, hand over to Matt.
Good morning. It's lovely to see you all. Can you hear me?
No.
I promise you I'm switched on. I must have changed to mute by mistake. Sorry. There is one notice, and that is that the annual church meeting is after this service. So if you would like to stay, then please stay in your seats. If you would like to leave, then please just indicate to the stewards that you need to leave, and they will show you out. So wait till the steward shows you out, please, at the end of the service, if you don't want to stay for the church meeting. I would like to start by saying it's lovely to see all your smiling faces, but I can't see your smiles. I know you're smiling behind there, and I know particularly that Martin and Janet are smiling, because they're the ones with the smiles on their masks. I can't see them at the moment. But if you can't smile behind your mask, apparently the sign language for smile is that. So if you want to smile and you feel you're not managing it through your mask, and you can do that. I've got lots of people smiling at me now, so that's brilliant. Thank you.
Lovely.
If you know me, you'll know that it's a joke a minute in my house, but they mostly don't come from me. Well, I've got a joke for you this morning. How many Anglicans does it take to change a light bulb? You probably know, but I'm not going to ask you to say it because you're all behind your masks. It takes 10 Anglicans to change a light bulb, 1 to change the light bulb, and 9 to talk about how good the old one was. Thank you. Thank you for laughing, but I've got a better one. Here's my new version of that joke. How many Anglicans does it take to change a light bulb? 100. 1 to change the light bulb, and 99 to work out how to get the light out to all our neighbours and our community. That's my new version. So let's start our worship together. And if you can, please stand. And I didn't check that you've all got a service sheet. It's either on your devices or in your hands. Is there anyone who can't see the words? Chris can't see the words. Is there a steward who's got any spare copies? Oh, he's looking at Phil's. It's all right. Are you happy with that? Yeah. Anybody else? Wave if you've got the words. Up at the front, Margaret's not got any words at the front. Are there any words? Colin, are there any words, spare words? Are you all right there, Margaret? Lovely. So, please do respond to the words in bold. Today we worship His joy in our hearts.
Sorry, I'm a bit overcome now. Today we praise His song on our lips. Our voices echo the angels' cry,
Holy, holy, holy. Holy is the Lord God Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Now,
before lockdown, sorry, I'm going to get worse, not better.
Before lockdown, we learned how to say the peace to each other, how to share the peace in sign language. So I thought we would start our service by doing that, and we can all do 360 degrees sharing the peace with each other. I would just remind you how we did it. So start with your hands at the top like that, and we go down in a curve and hands out. So peace be with you, and you don't need to say anything. So may the peace of the Lord be with you. As we're good Anglicans, we're going to stand and sit and stand and sit, so please do sit down. We've got two hymns, and we're not going to be singing them, but we will listen, of course. The choir will sing them for us. So the first one we're going to sit, and the second one, which is at the end of the service, I will ask you to stand. So see how that feels. So let's sit to listen to Love Divine, All Loves Excelling. Thank you, choir.
Thank you.
pause for a moment as we reflect on this last week. And let's prepare to receive God's forgiveness. We say together, Father God, we know that we have done things wrong, things that have hurt you, hurt your world and other people. We are very sorry. Thank you for sending us the gift of your Son and showing us how much you love us. Thank you for the good news of your forgiveness. Please forgive us now. Amen. May the God of love bring us back to himself, forgive us our sins, and assure us of his eternal love, in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now Sarah is going to come and bring us our reading.
From Matthew chapter 22, verses 34 to 46. The greatest commandment. Hearing that Jesus had silenced the Sadducees, the Pharisees got together. One of them, an expert in the law, tested him with this question. Teacher, which is the greatest commandment in the law? Jesus replied, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the first and greatest commandment. And the second is like it. Love your neighbor as yourself. All the law and the prophets hang on these two commandments. Whose son is the Messiah? While the Pharisees were gathered together, Jesus asked them, what do you think about the Messiah? Whose son is he? The son of David, they replied. He said to them, how is it then that David, speaking by the Spirit, calls him Lord? For he says, the Lord said to my Lord, sit at my right hand until I put your enemies under your feet. If then David calls him Lord, how can he be his son? No one could say a word in reply, and from that day on, no one dared to ask him any more questions. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
We're going to sing a song. We're going to have some feedback and then sing a song. This is one I've done loads and loads of times in primary schools, which normally involves lots of children joining in. Because we can't do that, I get to make an idiot of myself on my own, which is marvellous. It's got some actions to it, so you'll see the words go shine from the inside out, the world can see you live in me, and then you know me, Jill's shaking, but I missed a bit out. No, you know me, love me, feel me, send me. But the actions go like this. You can do it in the comfort of your own seats and pretend there's no one else around you looking at you while it happens. So it goes like this, it goes shine, from the inside out, so the world will see you live in me. And then again, shine from the inside out, the world will see you live in me. And again, you know me, you love me, you feel me, and my favourite bit of the whole song, you send me, which is great. And then it goes back to that again. There is a point where the know me, love me, feel me, send me bit gets quite quick, which is really exciting for me. Probably less so for you. So, why don't you, we'll stay seated down because that's the safest and less embarrassing thing to do. Can I just cue up this? Oh no! Technological disaster. Let's try that again. Oh, yourselves ready.
Shine from the inside out, that the world will see you live in me. Shine from the inside out, that the world will see you live in me. You know me, and you love me, and you fill me.
Ready for this game?
So send me to shine from the inside out, that the world will see you live in me. Shine from the inside out, that the world will see you live in me.
This is the bit where you're just going to kind of freestyle, whatever you fancy.
Shine from the inside out, that the world will see you live in me. Shine from the inside out, that the world will see you live in me.
It's quick, mate.
Know you love me, feel me, send me. Know you love me, feel me, send me. Know you love me, feel me, send me. Inside out, so the world will see you live in me. Shine from the inside out, then the world will see you live in me. You know me, and you love me, and you feel me. So send me.
It gets quick again.
Know you love me, feel me, send me. Know you love me, feel me, send me. No, you love me, feel me, send me. To shine.
Be the source of it, man. That was fantastic. Marvellous. That was superb. Great stuff. Now, I don't know what radio stations you listen to, and I can't ask you, and you can't tell me. The social media output of KISS FM, which I understand is a contemporary urban and dance music radio station, that's me all over. It's mostly concerned with the goings on of the various celebs, their social media output, so the stuff that goes on Facebook, Twitter, TikTok, the other one, Instagram. You get all the stuff about celebs, their love lives, their homes, their cars, their holidays. So I never normally see it on any of my social media stuff. However, in the last couple of weeks, something popped up from KISS FM, which kind of surprised me. It was a result of a survey they'd taken of the top 10 primary school hymns, which is not part of their normal output. You don't normally get grunge, whatever, followed by what we're about to talk about. Now, you can't speak to each other, so you're just going to have to think to yourself. Your favourite primary school hymn song. Something you did. So for some of us, that would be not so long ago. Some of us, slightly further along ago. For some of us, let's just not talk about it. So, your favourite primary school song. So, okay, this. Bear in mind that the listenership of KISS FM is going to be 20s, 30s, so this might not match yours, although some of these have been around for a while. So I'm going to call out the top 10, not in the order. Stick a hand up if this was your favourite, okay? And then I'll tell you the top three. So, Shine Jesus Shine. Lord of the Dance. I don't know this one. From the Tiny Ant. Oh, yes, yes. You'll have to sing it to me later. That's okay. From the Tiny Ant. Okay. Cauliflower's Fluffy. Oh, we know it. Excellent. He's got the whole world in his hands. Yeah, that was a funny. Give Me All in My Lap. Bizarrely, that's one of the favourites of Wayne's comedy. Colours of Day. I haven't been checking the cheap seats upstairs. All things bright and peaceful. Ah, there we go. That's it. There we go. One more step. I love the run it down. Yeah. This little light of mine. Yeah. If I was to ask the kids in the schools that I've been in before, that our God is a great big God would be their favourite. Because that's mine. Okay, so the top three. Okay, this is the top three greatest, apparently, hymns from primary school. And number three, Shine Jesus Shine. Number two, Give Me Oil in My Lamp. And number one, in a million years, I never would have guessed that Cauliflower's Fluffy. If you can spot God in that particular school song, you've done well. But was it the greatest song ever sung in an assembly? Possibly not. If your cauliflowers are fluffy, I'd suggest you overcook them. Ideally, al dente covered in cheese sauce. That would make it the greatest. But the greatest of various things. We heard an expert in the law ask Jesus a question this morning about the greatest. Teacher, says the expert in the law, which is the greatest commandment in the law? It's a good question. The motive for asking it, I don't think, was particularly good. But it's still a good question, nevertheless. What is the greatest commandment in the law? And if we didn't have Jesus replying in front of us, if we didn't know what Jesus said, I wonder what we would have said if we were asked the same question. I guess we could probably name the Ten Commandments. We could certainly have a good stab at it between us. But the question that Jesus had was more extensive than that, because there were 613 commandments in the law of Moses. Okay, 613, not just the 10, that's the easy bit. This is 613. And those laws, and you can read them in Leviticus, Deuteronomy, those early books of the Bible, they cover everything from how to treat strangers, the right way to do business, what you can eat and what you can't eat. They cover the whole of life. And which is the greatest of those? If Jesus only had to answer from the 10, I suppose he could have said, might be easier, don't kill, good commandment. Don't steal, good commandments are really important. But they start with God saying, I am the Lord your God, have no other gods before me. And if you just had the 10, I think, you could say, that's probably the greatest of those. But what does Jesus go for? When Jesus is asked, he says this, love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. It is there in the list of 613, and it encapsulates so much of what following Jesus is all about. But being Jesus, there's an additional response. Jesus goes for the bonus answer. He's asked for the one greatest law that Jesus, and he's the Son of God, so he's allowed to add something else afterwards. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your minds. And the second is like it. Love your neighbour as yourself. So why mention both? Well, Jesus explains himself. It's because all the law and the prophets, says Jesus, so everything, all of those 613, all of the 10, they are summed up by those two commandments. They're covered by those two. They tell us the entirety of how we should live. Think about the other commandments from the 10. Don't steal, that's loving your neighbour. Don't murder, that's certainly loving your neighbour. Have no other gods but me, that's loving the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, and mind. And throughout Matthew's Gospel, and that's where we are in our weekly readings at the minute, Jesus has been keen to see what the law means in action, what actually happens with the law in real life, not a kind of fuzzy thing over here, and we're kind of thinking about this is the theory. Jesus is interested in the practice. Near the beginning of his gospel, Jesus gives a large crowd of listeners in the Sermon on the Mount a whole list of people that God would bless. And some people, hearing that, they said, this is new, this is fresh, this is different. Perhaps this means that Jesus is saying, we've had enough of the old law, we've got some new stuff. But Jesus isn't saying that at all. He says himself, I haven't come to abolish the law, I haven't come to get rid of it, I've come to fulfill it. And by that he means he's the one who does that, he's the one who is the law incarnate. When he acts, he does so perfectly. Nobody loves God with their heart, soul, and mind more than Jesus. No one loves their neighbor more than themselves than Jesus. And that greatest law should have an impact on us as well. There's three things: loving the Lord our God with all our heart, soul, and mind. When we learn about God, when we search him out, when we discover the truth about him, when we keep our intellect focused on him, that's loving with our minds. That's up here, that's head stuff. But that's not it, because that would be dry and dark. When we relate to God on an emotional level, there's times when we're lost in wonder, love, and praise, to quote the hymn. Those are the moments when we can love with our whole heart. And then loving God with our souls, I think that's a bit harder to kind of sum up. But perhaps the best way would be to say that when we love God with our souls, we love him with our cause, our personality, our inner self, our identity, our being. To love the Lord our God with our souls means to love him in the way we live, in the choices we make, in the behaviour and lifestyle we adopt. And why is that so important? Well, there was an American author called Brennan Manning. And Brennan Manning once said this: the single greatest cause of atheism in the world today is Christians who acknowledge Jesus with their lips, walk out the door, and deny him by their lifestyle. That is what an unbelieving world simply finds unbelievable. So, a moment of honesty. It's a great thing to have a mask on, because you can't necessarily tell what people are thinking. A moment of honesty. We could put our hands up and admit to it, but I'm not going to suggest we do. We might nod quietly. Are there people, when it comes to loving our neighbours as ourselves, are there people who are easier to love than others? Yes. There's others, maybe a relation who takes us for granted. A child in our class who is just me. The constant demands of a neighbour or a work colleague. It's not easy to show the love that we should. And even those who have spent a lifetime following Jesus, we can say in all honesty, we are not the finished article, if only. Our hearts haven't been renewed in one fell swoop. It's an ongoing process. It's a continuing progress. But the demand to love God and my neighbour is how we will draw others towards the God we love. Our new Archbishop, Stephen Cottrell, who was my diocesan over in Chelmsford, he often used to say he only had the one sermon. And that's what he did every time. I kind of don't necessarily agree with him. I think he had different sermons, but certainly the theme was always there. And I found myself doing the same. is I want to see people come to know Jesus in the way that I do. It is the most important thing that's ever happened to me. It's life-changing. It's changed my life. I want other people to experience that as well. So we will come back to that again and again and again. We have a question for us to finish with this morning, and it's about the greatest. Not what's the greatest childhood hymn, not even what's the greatest law, but what is the greatest thing in your life? My Twitter bio says how I try to live, and I don't always succeed. The things I love. And it says I love God, my family, my Mac, and a nice bit of cheese. But that's the order. God first. Is that the thing I love the greatest? I hope so. What's the greatest thing in your life? How are you going to show it? Let's pray. Heavenly Father, Jesus tells us how to live. Living lives of love, loving our neighbours as ourselves, and loving you with our hearts, our minds, our souls. We have Jesus as a pattern. Heavenly Father, help us to love as he loves, so that we may draw others to you. We pray these things in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
We're going to have a musical reflection played by Greg and sung by Joanna, and afterwards there will be a minute of silent reflection. Thank you.
Thank you.
Now I'd like to invite John and Catherine and Evie, not Evie, John and Catherine to come and lead us in our prayers. Thank you very much. Respond when we say, Lord, hear our prayer, with, and send your spirit. There will be short pauses during these prayers to allow God's Holy Spirit to prompt us with the places and people on our hearts that need particular prayer. Lord God, we sit in this holy space once more, in your presence. Heavenly Father, whose spirit is freedom, we thank you for the freedom we enjoy in this country, and we think of the many people around the world suffering censorship and persecution. We pray for those facing brutality from the police and other forces of law, and those who are carrying it out. We pray for people caught in human trafficking and slavery, and for those who operate the networks, that they would know your cleansing light and peace. We pray for those crying out for justice and struggling to have their voices heard here at home as well as abroad. Lord, hear our prayer and send your Holy Spirit.
Heavenly Father, God of healing and reconciliation, we hold up our world and our country, divided by anger and conflicting ideologies. We fervently pray for your healing and peace. May the leaders of the nations have their eyes, minds, and hearts opened, and may they turn to you. May they govern for the genuine good of all, being especially mindful of the poor, the sick, and the needy. Give them wisdom, integrity, clarity, and courage to look beyond self-interest and short-term thinking. Lord, hear our prayer
and send your Holy Spirit.
And we pray for ourselves, the family of Jesus here at Christ Church. We thank you for being able to worship back in our church. Thank you for the creativity and skill of those who worked so hard during lockdown to set up and continue Christ Church Without Walls. We pray that anyone who encountered you for the first time through this would be encouraged to build on these connections. We hold up Simon, our vicar, as he gets to know us and takes on the role of leading us. And we pray for Jill and their family too, as they settle into Cheltenham.
And at this point, we bring to mind as well the names of those who are sick. Some of them will be known to us, some will be on the notice sheet. In a moment of silence now, we just hold them up to God. And similarly, we pray for those recently bereaved. Lord, hear our prayer,
and send your Holy Spirit.
God of the children and the childlike, a prayer from Evie. Thank you for your amazing creation. Thank you for all the living creatures, bees, pandas, cats, otters. Please help us to care for our world and help us to be less greedy. Show us that each of us can do something good, however young or old we are. And we thank you for the work, in particular, of Sir David Attenborough and Greta Thunberg. Lord, hear our prayer
and send your Holy Spirit.
Father God, you gave us the greatest commandment, that we love you and one another. May we be willing to see through your eyes. Keep us looking out for others, even when our own energy and motivation feels low. Give us the grace to be of good courage in these unsettled times, and bolster our frayed hearts. And remember your promise that you will never leave us. A prayer by E. Everett Hale. O God, give us the strength to look up and not down, to look forward and not back, to look out and not in, and to lend a hand. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen. And we finish by praying in the manner that Jesus taught us, saying together, Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. The kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
So we come to our final hymn. Please would you stand as we listen to the choir singing All My Hope on God Is Founded.
Thank you.
And let's say our closing prayer together. Father God,
in this coming week, help us to listen to you. Help us to speak about you. Help us to live for you. Amen.
And may the Lord bless you and keep you. May his face shine upon you. May he make himself known to you and give you his peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit remain with us all now and forever. Amen.